Hi, Center School friends. Welcome back to your Fitness Friday. Today we have a fitness follow along to music to warm up our bodies, get those heart rates up, and get our muscles working. All right, friends, let's go ahead, find your personal space, and let's start moving. Here we go. Let's run in place. Run in place. hot supper and crispy mini. Just keep going. It feels so good. Great job. All right, crispy position. Let's do some push-ups. Bend. Awesome job. Feeling that upper body strength. Two more. Stand up, top. Let's do some jumping jacks up and in. On some gymnastics moves. But in order to do that, we need to practice our balance and our strength and our flexibility. So we're going to warm up our bodies doing a little balance, strength, and flexibility work. And then we're going to learn a couple of tips and tricks for doing things that we'd like to do in gymnastics. First, though, I want to make sure you have plenty of space. So make sure you're in a room that you're not going to kick anything. You have enough room that if you were to stand in a T with helicopter arms and move back and forth, you have enough room, all right? Also, make sure you have a soft surface or a mat to land on. I have a mat right here so that when I'm doing things, like I'm on my hands and I'm kicking up to do things like a handstand, I have enough room here. Make sure you give yourself that space, all right? When you're ready, let's go ahead, back up onto your space, find your room. We're going to go ahead and get started. Let's warm up those legs here. Warm up our body. Take a deep breath in and reach those arms up high. And take a big stretch to one side. And then reach down and try to touch that foot. And a big stretch up and over to the other side. Reach down for the other foot. And then come all the way up and reach side to side. Side to side. Good job, everyone. And now reach down for that opposite toe and windmill back and forth. Back and forth. Back and forth. Good job, boys and girls. All right, take those arms high and then take them down low. Bend into one leg and Spider-Man crawl. Back and forth. Side to side. Back and forth. All right, now lift those hips up and pull forward. Try to get your hands towards the ground. Good job, everybody. All right, take those hands on your hips and lift up about halfway so your back is flat. Take your arms out to a T and then reach up to one side. And then come back to the center and reach to the other side. Good. And then come back to the center. One more each time, reach. Center, reach, center. All right, I'm going to stand up tall on the back of my mat, reach my arms up, and then reach forward. Walk my hands out. So I'm in a push-up position or a high plank. In gymnastics, we really need to use our core strength in order to do our moves. So we're going to stay in our plank here, and we're going to bend our elbows down to a push-up, and then lift. And then bend those elbows in, and lift up. Bend, and straight. And one more push-up here. Bend, and straight. And good job. Now I want you to lower your belly towards the mat, and then stretch. Look up to the sky in your upward dog. Lift those hips up to your downward facing dog. And reach one foot up to the sky. Reach it as high as you can. And then take that knee in and take a big step forward into a lunge. Good job. Now try to straighten that front leg. See if you can touch your nose to your knee. Good job. Bend back into your runner's lunge. And then step to your push-up position or your plank. Now lift those hips back to your downward dog. And this time reach your other foot up. Reach it as high as you can, pointing your toe to the ceiling. And now big step forward like a runner starting a race. Great job, everyone. All right, try to straighten that leg out so you can touch your nose to your knee. And now bend back to your runner's lunge. Step back to your downward dog. All right, let's walk those hands up, back to our feet, and stand up tall. Roll your shoulders back. All right, take those hands back on your hips for balance. Bring one leg up to stand like a flamingo here. Now I want you to kick that foot out, see if you can hold it. You can start to lift your foot up. Good job, you can reach those arms high, bend it back in, and then fly it back behind you like an airplane. Awesome job, try to reach those toes to the sky. All right, now I want you to look in front of you and take your fingertips down and try to keep kicking that foot up towards the sky. So we're balancing on one leg here, the other leg is back, your hands are on the ground, maybe you can plant your hand, you can bend with that standing leg if you need to. All right, friends. Bring those arms up, try to take that leg with you. Stand like a flamingo. And now take it down. Let's stand like a flamingo on the other side. Kick that foot out. Good job, and fly back like an airplane. Great job, everybody. All right, see if you can reach those fingertips down to the ground, lifting that back foot up as high as you can. Great job. Try to reach those arms back out and up. And then step it back. Take your hands down. All right, we're going to come into what's called a donkey kick. So these are good ways to practice standing on our hands and putting our body weight forward. When we do these, we'll start in our downward dog. We're going to lift one foot up. You bend through that leg that your weight is on, and then you press it up to the sky, like you're trying to kick into a handstand. So you bend, and then kick up. Bend, kick up. Just do a couple like this. And then maybe you'll kick all the way up and feel yourself hold in your handstand. When we do our handstands, we really want to press through our shoulders, take our hands nice and wide. So show me just like this. Our hands are wide. We press through those shoulders, we grip through our fingers, to use our arm strength here. All right, let's try those donkey kicks again. So your hands are down, like you're in your downward dog, one leg is up, we bend that leg, it looks forward, and we kick up, until we hit that handstand. Keep on trying here, lift, and kick, lift, and then hold in your handstand. Awesome job, friends. Another way you can come into a handstand is if you take those arms forward and you shift your body weight nice and long like you're coming into that airplane and then plant our hands down. This way we have a little more momentum to kick up into that handstand. So from here, we take that big step forward, arms are high, you look where you're going, bend through that leg, and then kick up and back. All right, let's try that one more time, ready? Arms come high, bend through that leg, press up, and then Great job, everyone. All right, now that we can stand on our hands, we're going to learn how to do a cartwheel. When I do a cartwheel, I'm going to press through those hands again, except for instead of my hands being like this, one hand will be turned slightly in so I can push off. All right, now I'm going to watch here. I'm going to turn my mat back this way because I'll be going towards the side. I'll take off on one foot, my arms are here. I'm going to lift my body weight up like this. All right, I'll balance on those hands and then I kick my feet over my body. So I'm up to the sky, bend to that leg, look, and then land. Good, and then I can go back, look, and then land. Good job, everyone. You can try that a couple of times. Really work to press through those hands when you do those cartwheels and lift those feet up high. So one more time like this, I'm on my mat here, press through those hands, and then land up. All right, again, I'll press, and then land. Awesome job, boys and girls. So now we've learned a couple of different simple gymnastics moves that we can do. We're going to finish out by stretching our bodies a little bit here. So let's go ahead and reach those arms up to the sky. And I want you to take one hand down, one hand up. Grab for your foot with that back hand. We're going to kick into a dancer. So you kick your foot back, reach your hand forward, and then reach in opposite directions. Nice job, my dancers and gymnasts. Let's try it on the other side. You balance here, lift your leg up, grab for your foot, and then kick back like a dancer. And now lift up to the sky. Take those legs wide and just fold forward. You can swing side to side. All right, now I want you to come on down into a tabletop position. Reach your right foot back. So you're in a tabletop here and left arm forward in opposite directions. You'll reach, 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 and then draw your knee into your elbow. And then reach long, and then draw your knee into your elbow. Good job. One more reach, and then draw it in. And then reach long, and then come on down and try the other foot. Kick your other leg back, other arm forward, elbow to knee, and then reach, elbow to knee. And then reach, one more elbow to knee, and then reach, and then come on down in. Have a seat, crisscross applesauce, reach those arms. Super good job with our gymnastics practice today. We're going to go right into our cool down and stretch. So I want you to stretch those arms up overhead and then reach to one side. So all the yoga and the stretching and balancing we do in class, it helps us when we're doing things like gymnastics or dance. It helps us stay strong and balanced. It helps our flexibility. Reach over to the other side. So it's so important to do. Reach out for that toe, which is why we'll do it all the time in PE. All right, reach those arms up to the sky, stand tall. Fold it forward, reach for those toes. And now I want you to take your hands down and step back in your strong push-up position. All right, let's lower your belly to the mat. And then lift up, stretch to the front of your body in your upward dog. Great job, now lift those hips all the way up into your downward dog. Reach your left foot up to the sky and then step it in between your hands to your runner's lunge. Lift those arms up in your high lunge and then open up to a T like you're going surfing and you're riding your wave. Good job, everyone. Take that front hand, reach it up to the sky, big stretch. And then take those hands back down and then step back to your downward dog. Reach your right leg high. Big step, runner's lunge. Lift up. Open up. Reach to the sky. And then take those hands back down. Step into your dog. And tiptoe walk those feet to your hands. And take a big stretch all the way up. and then take your hands down. Awesome job, boys and girls. That was so good. So today we are going to finish up with talking about our health and fitness tip of the week. This week we are talking about nutrition in different food groups. So we have a couple of different food groups. We have our fruits, we have our vegetables, we have our grains, we have our proteins. There are so many different food groups, and we want to try to make sure we eat a balanced and healthy diet incorporating things from all of the food groups. So we can think about things like eating an apple with peanut butter, or having a healthy sandwich, whatever it is that you have to incorporate different food groups. I want you to think about the things that you eat and think about if you can choose to have more of the different groups all together. This goes hand in hand with when we talked about eating a rainbow. So we talked about eating all the different colors of fruits and vegetables. We do that when we incorporate different food groups. So this way we have plenty of nutrients for our bones, our muscles, and our bodies to stay strong and healthy. So for your lesson today, you can tell me what some of your favorite foods are that are healthy and that help you feel good and give you energy. And maybe you can try to figure out which food group they are in. All right, boys and girls, awesome job today. I will see you next time. Have a wonderful rest of your day. See you soon. Bye, everybody.